when it comes to a JK like mine, and let's say a 2022 JL Wrangler, what's the real difference between them? Is it the body design? No, they're very similar. Is it the powertrain? No. What really is the difference between the JK and the JL? I think when it comes down to it, I think the real difference between them is technology. I mean, let's be honest, okay? They've got the same engine. Most of them have the same driveline. So what's the real difference? Well, technology plays a huge role. Let me explain.
That's right. I am talking about the radio. The real primary difference between the JL and the JK is technology. Well, what does the radio have in the new models that the old models don't have that makes them a little less desirable?
Well, that's easy. The new models can operate your phones. So you've got Apple CarPlay and Android Auto. Yep, we don't get that lucky in the JK. But let's be honest. How many of you are getting frustrated with the technology that is in the new ones? Just because it says it can connect to your phone and utilize your phone, I have seen post after post after post of it won't connect. Apple CarPlay is shutting my Uconnect down. Android Auto is phasing everything in and out. Chrysler used to be an innovator in technology. It's really such a shame. The question is, if technology is the biggest difference, then why can't we just upgrade the technology in this one? I mean, think about it. I could go out and I could spend $65,000 on a brand new Rubicon so I can get a beautiful new Uconnect system with off-road maps and the ability to pair my phone, but I think for a few hundred bucks, I can get all those same features here and they'll be even better than the ones that Chrysler offers. Let me show you. All right, folks, so this is a new stereo system from Enon. It's called the GPA13. This is basically an onboard computer system that runs just like your tablet that's going to give you all that same technology. Here's the really cool part. Your Apple CarPlay and your Android Auto, 100% wireless. That's right. No more plugging it in and faulting out the radio. We're going to do it 100% wireless. The other really cool part is completely encased in this 10.5-inch screen in this radio is a 32-gigabyte hard drive that's running off of 2 gigabytes of RAM. Actually, that's a little bit better than my tablet now that I think about it. So we've got all your wireless features. We can control cameras just like the new ones, and we're going to give a nice facelift and an update to the JK so that I have all that same technology. And you know what? I don't have to go out and buy a new Jeep. So I'll tell you what, if you're along for the ride, let's get this thing installed and let's see how it works. Now, a couple quick things that I want to mention about this particular in-car entertainment system. Okay, one, this is brand new. In fact, from what I understand, this is the very first one on American soil. I've been in contact with them for the last 6 months in hoping to find the perfect radio for the Jeep, and they let me know that this was something that they were brand new releasing right before the holiday season this year in 2024, and so they wanted me to test it out. So I promise you, there isn't another one like this that you've seen, because this one is brand new. The other thing that I want to mention is you do notice this is a very large screen. So the dash is going to have to come apart in the Jeep in order for us to get this installed. And I'm anxious to see what it really is going to look like. So come on, guys, let's dive right in, get the dash taken out of the Jeep, and get this thing hooked up, because I'm so excited to see how it's going to work.
For those who have seen my earlier videos, or who are relatively mechanically inclined, you know taking the dash out of the JK is actually super easy.
You got one 7mm bolt here, right where the power window controls go. You got one 7mm bolt here, which is on top of the dash, right in that little cubby up there. And then, of course, you've got one right there on that side of the steering wheel. One right there on that side of the steering wheel. And then the whole dash just pops right out. It's actually super easy. So now, all we got to do is pop these four bolts that are on the actual radio itself, pull the radio out, and disconnect it, and we should be about halfway there.
The whole process is actually super simple to install the radio. It's the other stuff that might get a little complicated. What could he possibly mean by the other stuff?
So what else does a JL have that a JK doesn't, in most cases? A backup camera. Well, a lot of your aftermarket radios are going to give you the option to run a backup camera and hook it up to the radio so that you can also have that same feature as the JLs. It's super simple. Basically, you just mount it, wire it up to power, which in a backup camera is just as easy as connecting to the lead on the reverse light so it comes on in reverse, and then sending the signal to the radio. But wait a minute. I already have a backup camera, because I solved this problem a little while ago, if you remember, by installing a rear view mirror with a live action camera going forward and back. So what are we going to use this one for? You know what else a lot of JLs have that JKs don't? I have an idea. How about a forward facing camera? We can mount this guy, let's say, right there, just like that. And then, if we tilt it down, I'd be able to see the trail. How cool is that? All right, let's see if we can figure out how to get this mounted to the bumper. I've always wanted one of those. Okay, so now that we have that mounted, now it's just a matter of running the signal wire up to the radio.
But that's at a much later step. Let's get back to putting the radio in.
Look, it's my fluffy cow. I got him up in Montana.
All right, since you probably already guessed, since I'm pulling out a doubled-in radio out of the dash, but I'm putting in a 10.5-inch screen, you would think that there would be modifications. But you know what? They made this even simpler than that. They give you a bracket. This bracket mounts in the place of the original radio, just like that. And then we could actually put the whole dash back together, because the radio itself is actually going to stick out past the dash. So like I said, this is actually a super simple install. Here, let me get this bracket in, and let me just show you real quick what this radio is going to look like. Because this radio was specifically designed for the JK, meaning that it was ordered specific for my vehicle, then all the wiring is already set and ready to go. Again, super simple. Here, let me show you. So these two plugs right here are the two plugs that are going to plug in to the factory wiring harness. And then these plugs are the ones that go into the back of the radio. It looks like a mess, all right? Don't get me wrong, but it's already pre-wired, set, and ready to go. Now, how often does that happen? Usually, you got to get a separate wiring harness, and you got to sit here and you got to splice a couple dozen wires in order to get everything to work. So seriously, Enon made this super simple. So the really cool part is all this space behind the radio actually allows for a lot of accessories. So before we fire this up, let's talk about accessories.
Accessories meaning if you've got an external amplifier and you're running subwoofers in your vehicle, this has the preamp out in order to attach that. Your backup camera, or in our case, our forward-facing camera. There are multiple different types of accessories that you can get for this radio at time of purchase, and all the wiring is still the same, and it's all still back there ready to go. With that much space, also allows a lot more airflow. So I would believe the radio would probably stay a lot cooler too. But what I'm really curious about is, does it work? So let's fire it up. Oh, that's actually kind of cool. Well, look at that. Now, that little icon that was just on there is because my rear lift gate is open, which is also matched up there. So that's actually really, really interesting. I like it. All right. So it looks like the radio works. Of course, I would actually have to shut the camera off, I think, in order to pair Bluetooth and everything with it. But from what I can tell, we've got a clock, speed, video, maps. And that's actually takes you straight to Google Maps, I'm assuming would work once we attach it to our phone. That's actually pretty slick. I actually like it. All right, guys, so I couldn't help myself when I started playing. So I got to show you this. As you can see, my phone is not connected with a wire to the radio. But in Bluetooth, we can set up your Android Auto. So it says Android Auto will turn on Bluetooth and pair your phone. Also, it will sync your contacts with this car unless you have opted out. Okay. So, bam, just like that. And you could tell the last place I called was Four Wheel Parts. Here is basically everything that a wired Android Auto would actually do. That was super simple, super easy. And of course, we can hop right back here to the home screen. I wonder if I can download OnX Off-Road directly to this radio. I'll have to give that a shot. We'll talk about that later. In the meantime, let's get everything back together and let's see what it looks like with the final fit and finish. Okay, so while I was putting it back together, I did notice one thing, and I don't know if they'll all be this way or if it's just because I got the very first one, but I want to show you real quick something that I had to do in order to make this fit. If you look, this is on the right side of the mounting hardware. You've got this little guide hole. This little guide hole matches that little nub right there. However, the pre-drilled hole that they put in here was not quite large enough for that pin to slide through. So that being said, I had to get a drill bit out and I had to widen the hole just a little bit. But that's okay. I mean, it's plastic. It's not that big of a deal. It's just probably an oversight because, believe it or not, the pin on the other side is actually a little bit thinner. Why Chrysler would make two different size pins for this thing, I have absolutely no idea. But now that we got that hole slightly larger, the dash should just snap right into place. And just like that, she snaps right in, and no worries. Now, you look at the mess of wires that's coming out here, and I don't want you to be discouraged, okay? It's actually extremely simple. As we've talked about in the past, Chrysler does run logic controls through the radio. So you do need this little guy. This is a little CAN bus that allows the logic controls to still run through the steering wheel. Plus, we've got a fuse box dedicated just to the radio. Probably a little overkill because it is fused, obviously, in the main fuse box. But that's how Enon decided to do it. And then the rest of it is just all of your auxiliary connections. Now, I did run connections for three USB cables, which you can see I'm going to have run into my glove box. One of them, which is this one, is if you do want to wire your phone directly to Apple CarPlay or Android Auto, that's what this guy's for. The other two are just regular USB inputs, which is great because I could use them to put some flash drives and actually store some music. The other thing that I want to point out in the wiring is you have one connection coming out of the truck, but there are two connections on this wiring. So I'm sure you're aware, in the JK model, there was two different options for stereo systems, okay? Now, I'm not talking about the regular CD player versus the touchscreen, okay? Which is what the Uconnect 110 versus the Uconnect 410 or whatever. That's not what I'm talking about. What I'm talking about is two different options for stereo systems. For example, you have your standard stereo system, which is usually your sport models or some of your lesser equipped Sahara models, Rubicon models, so on and so forth. And this is basically just your dash speakers and your overhead speakers. Then you have your Alpine system. Your Alpine system, which was an upgraded option for the JK, is the one that includes the powered subwoofer in the back. Now, what they did, and I thought that this was actually really clever, is they made it so that it doesn't matter which one you have. This wiring will work either way. So let's take a closer look at this wiring real quick before I go and plug this radio in. You'll notice, because I've got the Alpine system, this one has rounded edges on it. It's got all your speaker wires, your power wires, and your ground wires. Now, the other one that's there has all the exact same wiring in it, but it's square. It's not rounded over. When you look down in the harness, they're all actually daisy chained together. So, I wanted to point that out because I didn't want you to panic when you looked at this and say, hey, wait a minute, I've got a plug that doesn't go anywhere. It's okay. You're either going to use the square one or you're going to use the rounded one. It depends on which factory equipped stereo system was in the Jeep to begin with. Okay. So don't panic about that. Just make sure that all of these little guys, that are the accessories that come on their radio, all get plugged into the back of the radio where they belong. Each plug's a different size. Each plug is marked. You can't mix them up, so you can't screw it up. Seriously, even though it looks daunting and it looks complicated because you've got all this wiring that's hanging down here, okay? It looks complicated. It really isn't. Folks, this is actually super, super simple. That all it is just one plug into the dash, and then you have your plug for your antenna, for your radio antenna and your satellite, and then the rest of it just plugs right in. Seriously, no wiring, no splicing. It's super easy, so please don't panic about that. But now that we've got the dash back in place, now I'm going to go through, I'm going to plug everything in, and I'm actually going to affix the radio to the dash, because I'm really anxious to see how this is going to look. All right, guys. So there we have it. Still have access to my cell phone holders and my ham radio. That's nice. Can still reach my power windows, which is great. It otherwise, this thing is massive. This is so cool. Well, let's turn it on. Let's see how she looks. And there you have it, folks. She fires right up. This button here will get you into the apps. There's all kinds of different apps in here. If you have other video input sources. There are a couple of ways to connect them in the back of this radio. So such as if you had an Xbox or a PlayStation, believe it or not, I'm sure you could probably play it up here. We also have typical apps like Netflix and music and radio, and it's just this thing is actually really cool. It's basically a tablet that you can control right here on your dash. YouTube, which, you know, comes in handy because obviously that's what we're using right now. But check this out. What I thought was really neat is, remember I said I had to hit this button up here, I was going to wire in that camera? Well, it actually has a switch built right in. So there's the front camera, although it seems my front camera is actually upside down. I guess I'm going to have to fix that. But that's all right for right now. This is actually pretty neat. We've got all kinds of features and stuff to play with in here, folks, including, check this out, we do have the Google Play Store. So I'm sure we can download some other apps without any problems whatsoever. So what do you think? This thing is massive, it's awesome, and it pretty much is the last thing necessary to bring the JK up into the next century of Jeeps without actually having to go out and spending $60,000 on a Jeep. How freaking cool is that? Oh, but there's one more thing I want to show you. You ready? Here, check this out. I was able to download OnX Off-Road, and there we go. Now I've got all my trail maps right here on the radio, and I don't need to use my cellular device. How cool is that? All right, guys, so tell me that's not one of the coolest things that we've done to the JK. Not only does it rival the technology that you can get in the new JLs without having to spend that kind of money, at the same time, it has so many other really cool features that I'm so excited to go and get a chance to actually play with this radio. In the meantime, folks, listen, like I said, it's not even on the market yet. I got the very first one. So if you want one, I got a special surprise for you. There's a link in the description down below this video. Don't tell anyone. Just click the link. You can get it for yourself and show off in front of all your friends long before this thing actually hits the mainstream market. Oh, and to sweeten the deal, if you use promo code J4B10, they promised a special price just for you guys as my viewers. How cool is that? So, anyways, check it out, folks. I promise it's worth every single penny. This is actually one of the coolest things I've put in the Jeep so far, and I am so excited to go play with it. In the meantime, folks, if you have any questions, please don't hesitate. Put it in the comments down below, and I'll get to them just as quick as I can. In the meantime, stay safe, happy Jeeping, and we will see you next time.
And then let's go ahead and open the equalizer. Oh, look at that. You can't get any more fancy and technical than that, can you? And we can control them all individually. That's pretty badass. All right.